Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. What we've learned from the previous tutorials is that there's a key word here when creating Python code, and that is readability. In order to strive towards the code being more readable, the code needs to be presentable. So here we have PEP8, which is a style guide for Python code. PEP8 is a document that provides guidelines and best practices on how to write and present Python code. Now, the important word here is guideline. You don't necessarily need to follow this, but by having this guideline, and many do try to follow these guidelines, it means that any Python code that you read, it will be styled in a particular way which you are comfortable with, thus potentially making the code more readable. To find the PEP8 style guide for Python, just type in PEP8 into Google. It will be the top answer. Here we're looking for peps. .python.org. So it does come from the official python.org website. So what you might notice before that is that there is a PEP index. So there are guidelines and all sorts of information about different aspects of the Python programming language. And this all supports and helps you develop and create better Python code. So back to Python PEP 8. Throughout this course, we will cover different topics. And what I recommend is that you spend a little bit more time whenever you can and have a read through the associated documentation. Now, in this section of the course, we are discussing comments. And you'll see there's a comment section here. So it'd be well worth your time exploring and just reading through this once and maybe making a few notes, because this is going to provide you some guidelines in terms of how to present comments on the page. So it would describe, for example, when you should use a full stop, when you should use a space, how many spaces you should use, and so on, as well as giving you a general overview on how to create comments in your code. And like I alluded to earlier, it does have additional information about other aspects of your code. So if you're wondering how to name variables or functions or classes, then there is a whole bunch of information here in the naming conventions section. And this will give you a good idea of when to use lowercase, when to use uppercase, and so on. So again, it's definitely worth your time reading through aspects of PEP 8 as and when we introduce different aspects or different practices or different features of Python in this course.